Hey everybody, Tony Caridi along with WVU Athletic Director Shane Lyons. Welcome to our tour of the new and expanded west side of the stadium. Shane, I know that a year ago we literally were over on that side, and this may look very similar to it, but we wanted to give fans an opportunity to take a look because there's been a lot of things that have been going on.
Yeah, a lot of fans on the west side never had the opportunity to go to the east side, so you know, our goal was to make it somewhat a mirror image of the east side, but just to see the change again on this side in 1 year has been very dramatic.
All right, so let's start off here. First off, we are located right now at the southwest gate, and one of the big things, Shane, is that this now is going to be available for ADA folks that need to get into the stadium, and you've got elevators that have been constructed here. They will have an easy access in.
ADA bus stops will be here. They can come in through this gate, two elevators up to the main concourse. So it takes out all the stairs for our guests.
And when you start to walk around here, it's just literally the width of the space. This can push a lot of people through at a very quick time, and I think that's probably the biggest thing, right?
Well, that's the biggest thing. We went from 42,000 square feet on this side to roughly 64,000 square feet. So you added almost 50% more space to be able to have more traffic flow, pedestrians. So that's the big key points of this.
I know one of the big things, Shane, with this entire project has been move folks away when it comes to concession stands, get them there for a comfortable location for them and allow for movement here, and there you go. You've got your concession stands, right?
Same thing on the east side. We put the concessions on the ends as opposed to in the middle, again, for allow free flowing through here. The other thing, Tony, that was on the east side that was a big thing of mine was to add the additional TVs. There's 75 TVs just on this side of the concourse. So no matter where you're at, you're gonna be able to see the game, standing in lines, walking the concourses. We have TVs all over, so you're never missing any of the action.
And if I'm not mistaken, Shane, those are speakers to listen to the radio broadcast, not the television broadcast, the radio broadcast.
That is the radio.
You'll see the designations. You've got women's, you've got men's, and you've got a family bathroom. So you've literally added on the men's side, but on the women's side, there has been a huge increase, right?
Just on this side alone, over 100 additional toilets just added on the west side, two additional family restrooms on this side, and a few additional urinals and different things for the men.
As we head in here, there's a lot of space from the moment that you come in through the door until you reach the facilities here, and obviously that's a thought process. You don't want lines dripping out there,
you
correct?
Don't want lines dripping out there, so of course, to be able to build the lines in here, obviously when it's cold, rainy, people can stand in line and not be in the weather as well.
Technology obviously is something that's always changing, and just like you did on the other side of the stadium, on the east side, you've got phone charging stations here.
This will allow fans to come in, quick charge their phones during the game.
Okay, so we've made our way across the stadium, and again, the new northwest entrance zone, ADA equipped for the elevators. Folks will come here, concession stands, and again, you just feel this width.
Now you kind of get the big picture of the direction that you're coming from, the entrances, again, coming into the gates, Tony, just like on the east side, the big area. Once you get into the gates, you're not bottlenecked, a lot of free flowing, come up the steps or have access into the elevator area.
Last but not least, the 10-ton elephant that has been in this stadium and people have been talking about is right here, and that is that brand new scoreboard, which literally gives the stadium an entirely different look because of its massive size.
It really does, and you know, looking at it straight on, you don't realize the difference between it and the other board, but it really almost doubles in size.
Obviously, it's done. There's some extra elements that are being added, but that has been turned on, and obviously the picture is something else.
It really is. You know, you had the fly through that's been posted up there, but to see that the other side with the flying WV, we wanted to make sure our brand is showing into the blue lots as well, in 365 days a year. So this board's something special, and it changes, as you talked about earlier, just the whole look of this stadium.
So folks, there you have it, a great look at the newly expanded west side here. But I guess your work is never done, right? Because you said earlier this week during your press conference that facilities are a number one on your list. You just want to keep expanding all around.
All around. We want to expand. Obviously, the last 2 years has been here on football, the fan enhancements. We have some work to be done for our student athletes in the medical area, the locker rooms, the team meeting rooms, which fans don't get to see. But again, our student athletes are in need of that, and that's what we'll focus on, you know, from the football facility. But again, Tony, you know, you just have to keep having a vision of where we're heading and how we continue to make enhancements.
Look forward to it. September 9th, West Virginia opens up the home season here against the Pirates of East Carolina. Make sure that you're here to check it out in this brand new looking stadium.